the ultimate blessing for which every man in this world has been ordained. You don't need a car. You don't need money on your account. The biggest ordained blessing of Almighty God to a man is to give you a vision. I'm talking about the vision of your life. It was the vision that Abraham observes that defines the circumference of his influence. The greatest revelation of your success, not survival, of your success is when you learn never to forget to look within when outside is failing. There is nothing you are looking for that is not inside you. There is nothing you see physically that defines you. Nothing. No man I have seen with vision does not deliberately pattern their life. It is not there. The true seed of a man with vision is that you don't do things by impulse. You do things by pattern. Put a certain order in your spirit. Jacob could not have served Laban without the mind of God preparing Jacob to produce 12 tribes. Every time of your life is patterned by Jehovah God because you love him and you're called according to his purpose. It's a character. It's something that has to be learned inside. It is in there. Because I'm a man with a vision, I carry a certain pattern, and that defines the state of my heart and the way I walk with my heart, the way I carry my heart. For out of it are the issues of life. You cannot have a certain grace to apply a vision with a very indifferent heart and spirit. What is in your heart, man of God? There is nothing God requires of a man like his heart. I tell people that's the primary place of purification of conscience. You're sanctified into obedience. You're sanctified into a purification of conscience. And then you're sanctified into the place of your commission. God cannot commission you in a certain way when there's no purity of conscience in your spirit. The purity and state of your heart defines how far you will go in God. And that purity of conscience comes from the primary places of obedience, the small things that cause you to keep quiet even when you have an opinion. Reconcile your vision with your state of heart in who you want to have made you to be. Every man of God must begin from the end of all perfection. That the realities of revelation in your spirit are not of the perfections, no, the end of these things. When you get to the end of all perfection and you meet the broadness of the commandment, the first thing that strikes you is humility.